If you want to find out all there is to know about the new Samsung Galaxy S5, then you've come to the right place. Let's kick things off with our review, what we loved, what needs work, and whether it's worth your hard-earned cash.
So, first impressions are, it looks pretty similar to the Galaxy S4, except now there's some kind of weird crinkle cut effect on the edge, which is still made of plastic, by the way. Where's our glamorous, strokeable, all-metal smartphone, Samsung? But flip the S5 over and you'll see the first of many positive changes. Gone is the shiny, glossy rear, replaced with a soft-touch surface that shuns smudges and feels nice against the palm. Another big improvement is the water resistance. You can accidentally drop the S5 in a toilet and it'll survive no problem, providing the back is firmly snapped into place and the USB port is covered with the flappy thing. And then there's the fingerprint scanner, cunningly built into the S5's home button. For the most part, it works well, as long as you swipe straight down and not too quickly. Impressively, it can also be used to authorize secure online payments via PayPal, a first for any smartphone. We did experience a couple of glitches where the scanner refused to work, but we're really hoping that this was just our review unit going a bit wonky. Power that bad boy up and you'll be greeted by Samsung's latest TouchWiz UI. It's typically bright and colourful, and we really like the funky new settings menu, even if it does go on forever. Overall, it feels a bit more streamlined, although the Flipboard-style magazine UI is basically just a rehashed Blink feed. And how better to enjoy the new TouchWiz, not to mention your movies, apps and games, than on that gorgeous 5.1-inch Super AMOLED screen. Like last year's model, the S5's display is simply stunning, chucking out full HD visuals that pop with vibrant colours. It's one of the best smartphone screens out there, proving strong competition for the latest LG and Sony flagships. The S5 is also a slicker, smoother experience than last year's S4, thanks to that Snapdragon 801 processor and Samsung's streamlined new TouchWiz interface. We happily smashed our way through power-hungry games like Asphalt 8 and didn't see a single stutter, although the Galaxy S5 did admittedly glitch out and crash on us a couple of times. Battery life is another highlight, matching the day and a half that we experienced with the Galaxy S4. I hammered the processor and the camera app all day and still had a decent chunk of life left before I slipped on my jammies and got tucked up with Teddy. Even if your phone is clinging onto the last shreds of life, you can turn on the dramatically titled Ultimate Power Saver Mode, which slashes tons of apps and features and leaves you with a black and white yesteryear style interface. Onto the camera, and the S5's 16 megapixel snapper takes typically crisp and detailed shots, boasting accurate colours. Like the S4, it struggles a little in low light, not quite matching Sony's Xperia cameras. But for general everyday use, you won't be disappointed, especially with the uber-fast shutter speed, which makes it as snappy as the iPhone 5S. Samsung has wisely streamlined the features menu too, clustering the likes of Drama Shot and Eraser Mode into the brand new Shot and More section. You get a few new tools, such as the hit-and-miss selective focus and the vastly time-consuming virtual tour mode. But the best new addition is the 4K video mode. The incredibly detailed videos look fantastic, at least for any poshos who've splashed down on a 4K TV already. Of course, these clips will absolutely devour your storage. A simple 3-minute video of your nephew picking his nose will eat up a whopping 1 GB of space. Thank God for memory cards, eh? As for other features, the S5 puts an emphasis on fitness yet again. Great news considering all the donuts scoffed in Recombu Towers. As well as a built-in pedometer, you get a heartbeat sensor on the back of the phone to tell you if you're ready to keel over. S-Health 3.0 is now easier to use too, showing you exactly how energetic you've been through the nifty widget. We also like the charming new Kids Mode, which gives your tykes a colourful desktop and kiddie-friendly camera app, among others, to fiddle around with.
Now, if you're weighing the S5 up with other handsets out there, you can't ignore Apple, which is why we pit the S5 up against the iPhone 5S. Take a look. As ever, the newest iPhone is a thing of beauty. Finely crafted aluminium frame, thin, light at just 112 grams, and rocking its distinctive fingerprint sensing home button. The Galaxy S5 certainly doesn't break the mold either, but it does sport a less shiny, more comfortable soft touch back. Make sure that all the important ports are sealed, and the S5 is happy to take a dip in up to 3 feet of water too. Don't try that with your iPhone though, you won't be pleased with the result. Naturally, the S5 is significantly larger in order to accommodate the extra inch of screen. It's still pretty light and plays Me Too by boasting a fingerprint sensor in its home button as well, but you can't deny that it's a convenient addition. It's a toss-up between the screens on these two phones. They both boast the same resolution and screen tech as their predecessors. A 4-inch Retina LCD on the iPhone and a 5.1-inch Full HD Super AMOLED on the S5. The Galaxy S5 screen certainly has the wow factor with incredibly vivid colours and good contrast. The 5S wins out for its brightness and its size. It may be an inch smaller, but it makes one-handed use that little bit easier as a result. iOS is one of the most popular mobile operating systems on the planet, and with good reason. The interface is clean and simple, eye-catching and super smooth. Samsung's newest TouchWiz interface is a major improvement running atop Android KitKat, but it still can get confusing. There are plenty of options to customize the interface, and the settings menu may be cleaner, but it goes on forever. The S-Health app and its ability to read your heart rate is a cool addition, if a little novel, and the My Magazine feed gives you the news you want to hear about in a Flipboard-style format. In essence, the S5 offers a ton of stuff out of the box, while the iPhone leaves you to pick and choose from the App Store, arguably giving you more control over what takes up space on your phone from the off. It's tricky to compare the muscle on show here. The Galaxy S5 has one of the most powerful chipsets of any Android device out there right now, the quad-core Snapdragon 801. User experience and heavy-duty apps like 3D games run flawlessly, so this thing will stand you in good stead on your average 2-year contract. Battery life that lasts over a day and a half, even before you reach ultra power saving mode, is awesome too. The 5S does its own thing. Its A7 dual core chip is the first to support 64-bit architecture, and there's nothing else really like it out there right now. This means that eventually we'll see some pretty powerful apps running on iOS devices, including the 5S. There just aren't really any out there right now to test this theory. You won't get the epic battery life or the breadth of connectivity options that you do with the S5, but you still can manage a day on a single charge. It's not just enough to offer a big sensor now. The 5S and the S5's cameras duke it out on the features department too. Both perform well across the board. You'll appreciate the iPhone's 8-megapixel snapper for its ability to automate everything, making sure exposure and color look as accurate as possible, especially now that it has a dual LED flash. Like the iPhone, the 16-megapixel rear camera on the Galaxy S5 can shoot HDR snaps and slow motion video, but it can also film in 4K, that's 4x HD resolution. The modes have been cut back, which makes it easier to navigate, but there are still a ton of options to choose from. Be prepared to spend a lot of time getting to know the camera's full skill set. If you want a phone built for creating and consuming media, then the Galaxy S5 is an entertainment powerhouse. The iPhone is the reliable alternative. Even if you've never used one, the learning curve is much smaller than that of the S5, and aside from the battery life, it still offers one of the best all-round smartphone experiences there is. In what's probably the closest matchup in recent memory, here's our comparison against Sony's new flagship, the Xperia Z2. If you're familiar with any of Sony's or Samsung's recent top handsets, it's more of the same in both camps. The new Galaxy S5 is a more complex beast than its predecessors, weaving together chrome touches and a grippy new textured back, but it still relies on a design that's mostly plastic. Sony's Xperia Z2 looks like it's wearing a sharp suit by comparison to the S5's velour tracksuit. Toughened glass and a milled aluminium frame look the part, even if this shiny coat is an absolute fingerprint magnet. Our biggest criticism would be that it hasn't evolved much from last year's Xperia Z1, while Samsung has clearly tried something new. Both phones are distinctive in that they each boast waterproofing, so fear not if you drop your phone in the bath, they won't mind. Samsung wins out with a couple of additional tricks in the form of a swipey fingerprint sensor for unlocking as well as making PayPal payments and a heart rate sensor for the fitness conscious stuck on the back. Media junkies are spoilt for choice with this pairing. If you like eye-wateringly intense colours, Michael Bay style, then the 5.1-inch Super AMOLED of the S5 is the display for you. Otherwise, the more accurate colours of the Xperia Z2's 5.2-inch screen might be the preferred option. Both rock full HD resolution too, so pictures, movies and games look pin sharp whichever phone you fancy. On the inside, both phones boast Qualcomm's snappy Snapdragon 801 quad-core processor. The S5 chip is clocked a little faster, but the Z2 has an extra gigabyte of RAM to play with. In real-world use, this means that both phones run buttery smooth, not least because they both run stylized versions of the latest Android KitKat OS too. The biggest changes have been made to Samsung's TouchWiz interface, and it's a lot cleaner than previous revisions, but we're fans of Sony's slick and sophisticated UI. Both support microSD cards up to 128GB, but if you want more inbuilt storage, the S5 is the only one that's available as a 32GB model. The Sony sticks with just 16. In the battle of the batteries, it's also a pretty even playing field. Both phones will see you through a day and a half on a charge, and in our experience, the Z2 gives up the ghost just ahead of the Galaxy S5, and what's more, the S5's battery is removable, which some might prefer. As camera features go, both phones are packed to the gills. Samsung decided to go big this year with a 16-megapixel snapper, boasting a more refined camera experience than previous Samis. It makes for some sharp shooting and works well in most conditions, not to mention you can film in slow motion, 4K, and get crazy with some unique camera features like its 3D video tour mode. But if Samsung went big, Sony went bigger. The Z2 rocks a mighty 20.7 megapixel sensor that goes toe-to-toe with the S5's camera. In most situations, we'd say the Samsung may just have the edge, but the Z2 is the undoubted king of low-light photography in this battle, and the one to go for if you plan on using your phone to document those messy nights out with your mates. The Z2 also matches the S5 with weird and wonderful shooting modes like augmented reality dinos and live streaming to Facebook, and it also offers up 4K and slow motion recording with its time shift video mode. Truth be told, even down to the wire, it's neck and neck. This could possibly be one of the closest comparisons in recent memory. Samsung has clearly tried hard to ensure the Galaxy S5 is a killer smartphone, while Sony didn't have to work as much to update last year's phone in order to keep it relevant. The look and feel of these devices is distinctly different. The Galaxy S5 is the colourful, playful court jester, whilst the sharp looks of the Z2 experience mean serious business. Whichever you pick, we promise, you'll be impressed. The trifecta of 2014 Android powerhouses wouldn't be complete without comparing the Galaxy S5 to HTC's One M8. It may not be waterproof and lose out on a fingerprint sensor, but it's got some killer looks and a unique camera. Let's see how it measures up.
From fingerprint scanners to dual lens cameras, the S5 and the M8 pack their own unique and wonderful features. But which one offers the most value and is more deserving of your hard-earned cash? If you're all about looks, then there's only one true choice here. The Galaxy S5 may feel solid and sport an attractive new strokeably soft rear, but the HTC One is the best looking mobile out there with its one-piece brushed metal build. However, the Galaxy S5 does have a couple of cool tricks up its plastic sleeves, including a nifty fingerprint scanner. Not only can you keep nasty criminal types out of your phone, you can use the scanner to authorize online payments. Great news if you're a shopping addict who's constantly forgetting your password. The S5 is also water resistant, unlike the HTC One, so buttered fingered users who've seen their smartphones die a watery death in the bogs might be swayed towards the Samsung. Both phones sport similarly sized screens, with the Galaxy S5's 5.1-incher only slightly more spacious than the HTC One's 5-inch display. They're both full HD 1080p panels, so your high-def movies will look gorgeous on either. But while the HTC One screen offers true-to-life colours, the Galaxy S5's Super AMOLED display goes for uber vibrancy, with bright colours really popping out. Both work well, but your favourite will probably come down to personal preference. There's little between these phones when it comes to performance, as they both rock a Snapdragon 801 processor that can handle the latest intensive action games with ease. However, the HTC One comes up trumps for battery life with a solid 2 days of use per charge. The Galaxy S5 just about managed a day and a half by comparison, although it does have a last gasp ultra power saving mode if you're desperate to wring out some extra life. Google Android is buried beneath custom overlays on both phones, which dramatically alter the look and feel as you skim through the desktops and the menus. We're personally bigger fans of HTC's Sense interface, with its handy Blink Feed homepage that delivers social media updates and the latest news direct to your eyeballs. However, if you're one of those jogger types, you'll love the Galaxy S5's built-in fitness goodies. The S-Health widget keeps track of your motions and shows how active you've been right there on your desktop. Not good if, like us, you prefer pies over Pilates. Bear in mind that you can download alternative newsfeed and exercise apps from the Google Play Store, usually for free, so these features shouldn't really influence your final decision. When it comes to cameras, there's a world of difference between these two phones. The Galaxy S5 goes for all-out megapixels with a 16-meg snapper that captures detailed photos and can shoot 4K video. The HTC One M8, on the other hand, uses a streamlined 4-meg ultra-pixel camera. The resulting photos are still impressively detailed when viewed back on a TV, but the camera's real strength is low-light shots, which come out brighter and much more attractive than the competition. The HTC One's dual-lens camera also allows for some cool visual trickery, such as the ability to alter a shot's focus after it's been shot. Samsung offers a similar feature, but it's much slower on the Galaxy S5 and you have to select a special mode first. The HTC One Zoe mode can also throw together short clips of your day into a funky, shareable montage. In the end, the two cameras offer very different experiences, but we're personally swayed by the HTC One's super fast and adaptable ultra-pixel snapper. Of course, if you're already on the 4K bandwagon, the Galaxy S5 may suit you better. All things considered, the Samsung Galaxy S5 is a powerful and feature-packed handset that we'd happily use every day. But it's the HTC One M8's gorgeous design, ultra-pixel camera, and incredible battery life that really deliver the killer blow.
Already got your mindset on Samsung's latest top dog? Then why not check out our tips and tricks to help you get the most from your S5 right out the box. The Samsung Galaxy S5 is brimming with features, so much so in fact that it's difficult to know where to begin. Here are our top 5 tips to get to grips with your Samsung Galaxy S5. Tip number 1, fiddly fingerprints. The S5's hardware home button goes toe-to-toe with the iPhone 5S, as it too boasts an integrated fingerprint scanner. For first time setup, drag down the notifications bar and head into the full settings menu, using the cog at the top of the screen. You're looking for the fingerprint scanner icon and the subsequent fingerprint manager option in the menu. Here's where you start swiping. Drag your finger repeatedly for a total of 8 times to complete the recording process, adjusting your fingers slightly each time. This helps the scanner recognize your print even if you swipe at an awkward angle. Once you've successfully recorded a fingerprint, you'll need to add an alternative password in case the scanner has an off day or you're not in a position to swipe your digit. Keep hitting OK until you find yourself in the screen unlock settings menu. Make sure to set the fingerprint scanner as your unlock method and then you're done. Happy swiping. Tip number 2, maxing out My Magazine. The S5's latest TouchWiz interface features a flipboard style newsfeed called My Magazine, which you access by swiping right from the main home screen. By default, you get a few feeds covering arts, business, and sport, but to really get the most out of it, you can customize the feeds by heading into the settings menu. Tap the 3 dots in the top right and you'll find yourself at the feed select screen. From here, you can add in more predefined feeds from topics like technology and photography, or by scrolling down, choose to include information from all of your favorite social networks, as well as sites like 500pixels and YouTube. Tick on any additional feeds, log in where necessary, and tick the auto refresh when opening feature before heading back to My Magazine. A final swipe down from the top should add in your new interests, and now you can stay up to date with all your primary interests in one place. Tip number 3, setting a smarter screen. This phone's Full HD screen isn't just pretty, it's smart too. Smart Stay was a feature on last year's Galaxies, and it's back on the S5. Heading into the display section of the settings menu will let you turn it off if you prefer a more conventional timeout. Another feature of the screen is the Adapt Display menu. Toggle through the various options under the screen mode to see if you prefer a fixed set of levels for color balance, temperature, and contrast, or choose Adapt Display if you want the S5 to optimize the viewing experience for specific actions like watching movies, reading books, or browsing the web. The bottom of the display menu has one last important feature. Popularized by Nokia's latest Lumia phones, Super Sensitive Touch lets you use a glove-clad finger or a stylus on the screen instead of just your bare pinkies. Tip number 4, prolonging power saving mode. You've probably heard of phones with a power saving mode. The S5 has one. It lets you dim the screen and switches off unnecessary extras when you need to save power. But this phone doesn't stop there. If you're really in a pinch, ultra power saving mode is there to save the day. It locks you down to a single monochromatic home screen with shortcuts for a few apps of your choosing, and that's pretty much it. Aside from allowing calls and texts, no other connections or features are on by default. Tip number 5, getting variety from your video. The 16 megapixel camera on the back of the Samsung Galaxy S5 is packed with features. Its top of the line hardware means that as well as taking great photos, it's got a ton of video options too. Open up the camera app and tap the cog icon to see the full settings menu. Video size lets you swap out the resolution and aspect ratio to save storage space, or lets you shoot in UHD. Ultra HD or 4K video takes up a lot of storage, so the phone limits you to 5-minute clips, but the quality of video is stunning, even if no one really owns a 4K TV just yet. Recording mode, meanwhile, opens up options for 60 frames per second super smooth recording, the sped up fast motion mode, or slow motion mode, which lets you slow down footage down to an eighth of its original speed. Pretty impressive stuff that might even put the iPhone 5S to shame. Hopefully you've now got everything you need to know to decide whether the Galaxy S5 is the phone for you. And if you still have any questions, just drop us a line down below and head to recombo.com for a ton more content on all of the latest smartphones to hit stores. Thanks for watching.